And for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Greetings, Kump. Today is Wednesday, April 23rd, 2014. I'm Jeff Drajan.
And I'm Marissa Petronella, and you're watching KTV Live, Heroes and Villains.
Well, Marissa, today is Money Day, as you know, and I have a fun fact for you about coins.
Let me hear about coins.
Well, did you know that every 15 minutes, Americans insert over 3.5 million coins into vending machines?
I didn't know that.
You did not?
No.
I didn't either.
And there's also another announcement. If you'd like to audition for the Builders Club Talent Show, auditions will be held in room 30, May 6th and 8th. Come to Miss Malloy if you're interested.
Well, without further ado, let's get into the news. Today's KTV holiday is National Coin Week. This week is for helping people understand the meaning of coins. President JFK made this week in April to help people think about coins. All people around the world celebrate this week by spending coins everywhere they go. People really appreciate coins this week more than ever, according to U.S. Mint, because they actually have a lot of value. This week, many people learn the history of coins.
Today's KTV birthday is Shirley Temple. Shirley Temple is a movie actress. According to Famous Birthdays website, she was a child star of Curly Top and Heidi and received a Juvenile Academy Award in 1935. She became a U.S. ambassador in 1974. Some of her best-known films were Glad Rags to Riches, Bright Eyes, For a Pack, and A Little Princess. Shirley Temple died this year. She would be turning 86 today.
According to CNN, a massive iceberg with an area almost twice the size of Atlanta is moving into the ocean off Antarctica and could threaten shipping during the Antarctic winter, scientists say.
George recently got a chance to ask a fantastic women's college coach a couple of questions. Let's pass it over to him.
Thanks, guys. I recently ran into Gino Auriemma, the coach of the UConn girls basketball team. He has been coaching at UConn for 29 years and has rebuilt their basketball program. I got the privilege to ask him a few questions.
This past year, you won your ninth NCAA tournament final, making your record 9-0 in NCAA tournament finals. Is it even a big deal winning the tournament anymore?
Well, winning the NCAA tournament is always a big deal. Looking from the outside, I know it may seem easy, but it is not easy at all. Not too many people know the work these girls and the coaching staff does to prepare for the tournament. We constantly are working hard, so it is still a big deal for us because it is always a good thing to have your hard work pay off.
Does this championship feel the same as the first one, Dave?
This senior class meant so much to me, so this championship meant a ton to me. Stephanie Dolson is such a fantastic young lady, and watching her develop into the person she is today meant the world to me. There was never a day when she wasn't in a good mood. She was a true pleasure to coach. She is one of my favorite girls I have ever coached, and I'm glad that she left with the title. Rhea Hartley is also a fantastic girl with a ton of talent. I will miss her in my starting lineup.
Was there any doubt you would lose in the championship?
Well, Notre Dame is a fantastic team. There's no denying that. However, we have so many offensive weapons like Brianna Stewart, Rhea Hartley, Stephanie Dolson, and Kalima Mosqueda-Lewis. It is hard to beat us.
This year, UConn's girls' record under their coach was 40-0.
So, my man Preston, you're here?
Yes, I'm here to catch you up with the sports.
Okie dokie.
So yesterday in the NBA playoffs, the Raptors beat the Nets with a score of 100-95. Oof. Also in the NBA, the Bulls lost to the Wizards 101-99, and John Wall was just money.
Woo! Oh.
And then in the NHL playoffs, the New York Rangers beat the Philadelphia Flyers 4-1.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah, it's good because the Rangers are beating the Flyers with a 2-1 lead, so.
All right.
See you later.
Thanks, Preston.
Recently, on the Cum Infinity blog, Greg Z wrote about who won the Masters Golf Tournament. Who won the Masters Golf Tournament? Is it A, Tiger Woods, maybe B, Jordan Spieth, C, Bubba Watson, or D, Phil Mickelson? The golfer is one of the few left-handed golfers. He also won the Masters in 2012. And the answer is C, Bubba Watson. Watson finished the day at 8th and under. Going into the last day, Bubba Watson and Jordan Spieth were tied at 5 under. According to Wikipedia, Bubba Watson is 35 years old and has a child with his wife, Angie.
Drug abuse is a growing problem in the United States. It affects many people each day and causes many deaths.
Would you rather be in the hospital or playing sports? Would you rather be getting your stomach pumped or hanging out with your friends? Would you rather be in jail or be in school? Would you rather live or die?
If you do drugs, you can become addicted and damage your brain. Drugs can affect unborn babies and destroy families. Decide to do drugs or won't decide about yourself, your family, your friends, and most
make it quick, because
even though you can be cured, the best way to prevent the unpleasant, awful side effects of drugs is to stay away from them altogether. Make the right decision to stay away from drugs.
Make sure to make the right decision when it comes to drugs.
So we have our first break in the show?
Yes, we do.
Team Delta, let's pass it over there.
Alright, Gennato, I am very happy it's coin day. I mean, I just love coins. I'm a coin enthusiast.
Alright, so, on that note,
like coins.
All NJHS members, make sure you report to the auditorium during first period for the induction ceremony so we can practice. So with that, pass back to you guys in the studio.
That was very good, Brenner, but I bet that he did not know that the first coins date back to the Lydians at 700 BC, a group of people who live in what is Turkey today.
I didn't know that. I don't think he knew that either.
He did not know that.
Let's get into the news.
All right. With the end of the year coming up fast, there can be many things that can distract the students. But every student must make sure to keep up the hard work up to the very last day.
Today I don't feel like doing anything. Just wanna lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone, so leave a message at the tone. 'Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything. I'm gonna kick my feet up, then stare at the fan, turn the TV.
Hard work, hard work. Hard work, hard work.
So make sure to continue the hard work.
So, Jeff, the weather, it's been pretty iffy.
Yeah, I know.
But today it will be rainy with a high of 61. Okay. Tomorrow it'll be sunny with a high of 61. And then it'll rain with a high of 66. And finally on Saturday there'll be a high of 70 but cloudy.
Okay, all right.
Not too bad. But
it's not. Thank you.
On April 29, 2004, the National World War II Memorial opened in Washington, D.C. to thousands of visitors. According to History.com, this memorial provides overdue recognition for the 16 million U.S. men and women who served in the war. The monument features fountains between arches that symbolize hostilities in Europe and the Far East. Although federal government donated $16 million to the memorial fund, it took more than $164 million in private donations to get it built. The monument was formally dedicated May 29, 2004 by U.S. President George W. Bush. The same website also stated that the monument is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it receives about 4.4 million visitors in 2005.
So, Foxtrot, we have a little break, last one.
So let's pass it there.
So we have a great show tomorrow. Yeah. I have a video going, and it's a challenge, and whoever loses is out of the whole competition, so it'll be very interesting.
And I have an interview on whether the students of Kumpf like pickleball or track and field better, so let's pass it back to you guys in the studio.
So tomorrow's show sounds really interesting.
Yeah, thanks for the info, guys. For even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Marissa Petronella and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Jeff Drajan. Have a money-spending day. Okay, go ahead.